Driving towards enemy territory, an armoured convoy of Peshmerga escort us beyond the front line. Just days ago, ISIS militants claimed these vast plains in nearby township of Makmur as part of what it calls its new Islamic State. That was until US airstrikes suddenly stopped their advance. This was one of the targets, artillery used to attack Kurdish forces, who for the first time were inspecting the results of the power unleashed by US fighter jets and Predator drones.
Well, this is the impact of a 500-pound laser-guided bomb, and as you can see, the US airstrike has completely destroyed the ISIS mobile artillery piece. But out here in the open, the militants are easy to attack. Once they move into urban areas, they will be much harder to fight.
For the Peshmerga, US air support is critical. Before it arrived, they were outgunned by the Sunni extremists, armed with American weapons seized from the Iraqi army, and were quickly losing ground.
I think it's US.
This is a US?
Yes, because this is the Iraqi army weapons.
But with Kurdish forces now receiving weapons directly from the US, according to local officials, they believe their soldiers can effectively fight the enemy. ISIS is bad. They're against humanity, democracy, everything that has to do with life. That's why we believe in the battle and we were able to win. But not everyone is so confident. These families who fled during the vicious fighting have returned to pack up their belongings and leave indefinitely, fearing ISIS, just kilometres away in a nearby village, will return. We're all afraid. The situation is bad. We think ISIS will come back and we don't feel safe. America has to help us, pleaded this woman. ISIS is evil. They behead children like my grandson. With virtually no one left in these vulnerable border towns, the Peshmerga are desperately hoping the US intensifies its campaign over the skies to help them in their desperate battle. Anna-Coren, CNN, Makmur, Kurdistan, Iraq.